The H1N1 flu hitting the tri-state schools hard. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Poello. Sandra is on maternity leave. 50 students are now reporting flu-like symptoms at Xavier University. And news says Laura Borchers is live on campus with our number one story. Laura.
Yeah, Cherie, it's no longer just a concern here at Xavier. The H1N1 virus is spreading. They have 7 confirmed cases here now, and more than 50 students are believed to be battling the swine flu. And almost all of those students are new kids here, the freshmen. It is such a serious threat. The Cincinnati Health Department is on site. They're helping to educate on stopping the spread and explaining the use of Tamiflu. The students here are being equipped to stay healthy. The university is working to put hand sanitizers all over, offering masks and even handing out gloves. Plus, they're doling out large bottles of cleaning disinfectant for freshmen to be used on dorm surfaces, from the doorknobs to the walls, anything that may host the virus. The school is advising anyone with even mild sick conditions to contact the health center, and they're stressing the same procedures the CDC encourages.
Self-isolate until your fever is gone. We've been giving out masks to students. We've been providing disinfectants. So we're also still pushing, you know, wash your hands, wash your hands, wash your hands.
And it's not just Xavier. A look at other universities in the area. UC tells me they have 2 confirmed cases at the moment. The University of Miami, they say they have 13 confirmed cases at the moment. And again, here, 7 confirmed, many, many more suspected. And I talked with the health department here in Cincinnati. They tell me you're going to see fewer confirmed cases because they're moving to a situation where they stop testing and go directly into treatment. I'm going to have more on that for you tonight at 11. Reporting live, Laura Borchers, News 5.